Good evening, this is Bruce and welcome to my shop again. Been a while, I've had a lot on the plate and been to the States during June to the summer bash, etc. And there's quite a bit to be told about that, but I'll do that on a separate video. At present, we've had a pretty... So at present we've had a full-on week this week, and I want to show you some of the things that I've accomplished and some of the things that are in front of us as well. Plus also today I spent some time down at the wood show in Perth, and also picked up a couple of items for my collection. So first of all, I'll show you a motor that needed an adapter for a gearbox, and we'll work our way through the other things as we go. So without further ado, we'll swing down here, and we'll try and come in a bit at the same time, and I'll come. There we go. Okay, so what we have here is this motor was mounted on a gearbox. The motor burnt out, and apparently not the first time. Problem being that obviously too small for the duty. So the motor itself had a coupling arrangement to go onto the gearbox, and that's the flange that goes on. And it bolted through onto this end shield, which went all the way out to here. And what it did in the first instance, and it also has this small gear on here. So I needed to make sure that with the newer, larger motor, we would have the shaft and to fit the gear on the shaft in exactly the same position it was here. So I took all those dimensions and then I worked back off this to get the right distance away. And what I did was I took this whole end shell part, which was like so, machine cut it off, and then machined it back. That came all the way down to here. Machined it back until I had an adapter thickness of the correct thickness that I needed for this new shaft. So we're still going to use this same adapter plate, but I also had to make sure that we can get bolts in. These four bolts, we can get them in to bolt into the gearbox. So what I've done is I've taken this is the end shield that comes off this motor. So I've worked out the distances, and I machined up a counterbore, and I drilled I countersunk these bolts. These were the bolts that held the bearing cap. They were just ordinary hexagon bolts. So I've countersunk them so that I can introduce these cap screws in there, and they won't interfere with the rest of the makeup. I then drilled, I stacked everything together. I machined this down with a counterbore. I machined this with a face and a leg, and what I've done is I've set it up and I've drilled it, and I've fitted a dowel pin in so that we can make sure that everything is going to go together correctly when they come to mount it, because it has to be mounted on, and only after that the gear will be fitted on the shaft. I've bored it, counterbored it, drilled the pin, and it's ready for thing. But all this has to go together in order to do that. So I made that pin, and then that pin locates all the pieces together. I won't press it in at the minute, but it locates all that. That will then go on, will go on here, and the gear will be fitted in, and that's at the same distance as it was in the previous motor. The way I went about making this pin was I took a shoulder bolt and I drilled through everything. I tapped this bottom section here, this end shield, and I screwed in, Loctited it in. This is the shoulder bolt, and then I cut the shoulder bolt off, and that become the dowel pin. So all that remains now is basically is delivery of that. So we've done that, job's done, out of the way and completed. We've had another job come in, and there's actually two of these shafts that they're off hydraulic pumps, and the area of the seal is worn, and also the keyway section is worn as well. So I have two of those to repair during the week. I've also got this set of rollers. Now this set of rollers has been made to produce the edging of a plate. I'll just take that out the other way. There we go. So this plate here is actually the side of a truck. And that's the form, it's a very old truck from the 30s, and the guys want to build a new walls on both sides of the truck. So they've produced these rollers, but that roller on the top edge here is producing, where that fits on, where that roller comes in there, it's producing a mark. So what we're going to do, what we're going to do is we're going to machine this down, fit a larger washer on there, and then and weld it in, and then machine it off so that that radius carries on further, and then there won't be any marking on that. But that's another job to come up. We have some bearings here. We're going to be producing here in Australia the Wright rollers under the blessing. That's better. Under the blessing of Keith Fenner, I'll be producing here in Australia the Wright rollers, either in a kit form or completely made. So I've got some bearings. I'm going to be starting on making up a type of those the Wright rollers here, and they'll be available for sale in the future. Another job we got in from the men's shed was a couple of chucks for bowl making for the men's shed, and they'd bought a new lathe, excuse me, but they weren't happy with the chucks, so they've got a couple of chucks, but the bush that comes with the chuck for mounting on the lathe spindle is the wrong thread. It's this is a 1-inch BSP thread, and they need a 3/4-inch UNC thread. So what I've done, because the difference between 1-inch and 3/4 is not enough to make a good insert, so what I've done, opted to do, is to make a full insert myself, a new bush. And that bush will screw in here, and that will provide them with a good true running of the of that chuck. And that another job I've done, this is a 1926 or 28, I'm not quite sure, model A starter gear, and I've sourced a new gear, or an unblemished gear, and I've mounted that on, and that's ready to go as well. Another job was a couple of old pipe fitting hose fittings out of a relic vehicle, and I was requested to produce some new ones, and this is a new one they had, but it's BSP and they need NPT, so they just wanted this particular one cleaned up, which I have, and I've made two other ones from an NPT bushes, machined them down, cut the grooves and so forth. Now that's ready for delivery. Another job I have is this nozzle, which is used for bead blasting. And I need to produce some of these. They're quite long, a small hole in them. And so I'm looking at options for making these. Another job that came in I went down to have a look. The same company that uses this nozzle for bead blasting, they also needed a new carousel to mount on their bead blaster, and that gets turned around. It's like a wheel that's driven by a part contact of a belt that runs past it and around and back to the motor. And on top on that, they need to mount these parts that they bead blast through. The ones they have are pretty agricultural. So I've made up a new pulley. I got a couple of parts cut up out of steel. I've joined those together, married them together, made the pulley out of it and machined it, and I've also machined a shaft, and now it's a matter of just making the adapter system to go with it. So we'll put that up here, see if we can go back out a bit more. We won't go out anymore, so I'll put it up here on top of this old motor. So this is the wheel. We're having a battery trouble here. We're going to have to come back on this. So anyway, that's the wheel that I've made, and there's a shaft. And that's the shaft. We're going to have to change the battery shortly, and we'll do a second one. And that's the shaft, and that shaft will go in here. I'll come back shortly.